The new M4 Mac Mini is a fantastic computer and an amazing value, especially if you buy the 256GB version. But if you get that, you're definitely going to need some external storage. So in this video, we're going to take a look at some of my favorite external SSDs and talk about the speed you can expect to get with them on the Mac Mini and which one I would recommend, whether you're a content creator, a video editor, or if you just need a little bit of external storage for your documents. So I like to break down external drives into two main categories. You get the standard SSDs that typically use USB 3.2, like the Samsung T7, the Crucial X9 Pro, and then you get faster Thunderbolt 3 or 4 or USB 4 style drives, like the SanDisk Pro G40 or the Oyen U34 Bolt. Also on the higher end, we now have Thunderbolt 5 drives, which promise even faster speeds. There's really not many options for those on the market yet, but we will talk about those in a minute. Depending on what you're doing, that will kind of determine what type of drive that you need. So if you're doing photo editing or basic video editing, then I typically say that you can get by with a drive like the Samsung T7 or the Crucial X9. These ones typically give speeds of about 850 to 950 megabytes a second. The next drive class up, there are some drives that promise speeds of about 2000 megabytes a second, but those use the USB 3.2 dual lane standard, which Macs don't support. So there's really no point in buying those drives because you won't hit the faster speeds on them. They'll be limited to the same speeds as drives like the T7 and the Crucial X9 Pro. So the next class of drives is for people who are doing a ton of file transfers. If you're moving terabytes of data on a regular basis, or if you're doing more advanced video editing with higher resolutions, multi-cam clips, then you're gonna want a faster drive like the SanDisk Professional Pro G40 or the Oyen U34 Bolt. The Pro G40 uses Thunderbolt 3. It gets speeds of about 2,500 megabytes a second on the read and the write. The U34 Bolt gets speeds that are a little bit faster. It uses USB 4, or it's also backwards compatible with Thunderbolt 4 and Thunderbolt 3 as well. I have the 8 TB model here, and this is the drive that I use on a day-to-day basis for all of my video editing. And I've been very impressed with the speeds of both of these drives, but if I had one to pick, I would pick the U34 Bolt because you can get that 8 TB capacity at a price that's still very expensive, but it's more affordable than the Apple internal SSD upgrades. The speeds that you can expect to get on these drives are all over the place. So with the USB 3.2 drives, you're going to get speeds of about 850 to 950 megabytes a second, which is really fast if you're moving gigabytes worth of data, but if you start moving terabytes of data, these two drives do start to throttle a little bit under heavy load. So these are gonna be better for photo editing or basic video editing. If you're doing more advanced video editing, or if you're moving terabytes of data, you're really gonna want a faster, more prorated drive like the SanDisk Professional Pro G40 or the Oyen U34 Bolt. These drives can both hit speeds of between 2,500 and 3,000 megabytes a second. The Oyen one is a little bit faster than the SanDisk one. It's also a little bit bigger as well. But I love both of these drives. These are the two drives I use the most for day-to-day editing. I typically use the Crucial and the Samsung to offload projects whenever I'm done with them. I have done some editing on these and it works fine, but I just find I get better performance on the more professional rated drives like the Oyen or the SanDisk. Now, if you don't want to get a drive that's pre-built, Satechi actually has this enclosure that uses USB 4 and it gets really fast speeds. This is the fastest external drive I've used on my Mac. Probably the biggest reason I don't love to recommend getting enclosures like this is because you have to pick your own drive in it, which it's really easy to set the drive up in it. You just insert it, hold it down with a little stopper, and you put the cover back on it. The problem with these kind of enclosures is there's really no way to guarantee the speed you're going to get on them because the manufacturer of the enclosure doesn't necessarily test every single drive with it. So there's really no guarantee of how well these are going to actually work in the real world. But typically with the pre-built drives, they have more data from a lab, so you can get a better idea of the actual speeds and performance to get out of them. Now finally, if you want to be working with more than two external SSDs at once, then I really recommend the SanDisk Professional Pro Blade system. SanDisk did send me some of these for free to review. I loved them so much that I actually bought another 10 of these Pro Blade drives, and I bought a second one of these stations. So you plug this station into your Mac Mini, it has Thunderbolt ports on the back of it and also a power port for this, and you can use up to 4 of these Pro Blade magazines. So these come in 1, 2, or 4 TB, so you can load this up and have 16 terabytes of very fast storage. They get speeds of pretty close to 2,500 megabytes a second as well. So I really love this system for editing videos whenever I need to have a ton of different files in different locations. Now on the higher end of things, there are going to be the Thunderbolt 5 drives soon, like OWC has one that's coming out. The problem with those drives is they're gonna be very expensive, quite a bit more expensive than the Pro G40 and the U34 Bolt for the same capacities, but those are gonna give speeds all the way up to 6,000 megabytes a second, so pretty much double what these drives are going to be offering. So if you need the absolute highest speeds, then get the Mac Mini M4 Pro so that you can have those Thunderbolt 5 ports and those faster drives, but just know it is going to come at a greater cost. So to tie it all together, which of these drives should you buy? For most users, you can get by with the Crucial X9 Pro or the Samsung T7. These are both really compact drives, and whether you use the ports on the front of the computer or the back of them, you're still going to get the same speed, and it'll be about 850 to 950 megabytes a second on read and write, which is perfectly fast for any photo editing and also for most basic video editing. But if you're a more advanced user doing multi-cam edits or just more data movement, I really recommend getting the SanDisk Pro G40 or the ONU 34 Bolt, because these are really designed to be run for a long period of time. They both have aluminum cooling cores, and I have no issues with either of these bogging down even after using them all day long. They also get speeds that are about 3 times the speed of these, so you're gonna be able to move a lot more data a lot faster. Finally, if you're looking for a more custom workflow, you can get an enclosure like the Sateki USB4 enclosure and get speeds that are faster or just as fast as the U34 Bolt and the Pro G40. Just note you are gonna have to provide your own SSD for it, and there's no guarantee of just how well the performance will be on this under heavy load. And lastly, we have the SanDisk Professional Pro Blade system. It does take a little bit more work to set up, and you have to deal with the individual magazines, which can be a little bit of a pain to keep track of which one is inserted into which slot, but this is a really great modular system if you want to build up a collection of a ton of drives. If you have any questions about any of these SSDs, or if you think I missed one, leave a comment down below. I'd love to hear it. Like this video, subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on any upcoming content.